Russian diplomats in Australia haven't been expelled yet, but the government today confirmed it is looking at following the US, UK and EU in taking the extraordinary step of personally sanctioning Vladimir Putin. The Russian president's unprovoked war has also seen his country stripped of several major sporting and cultural events.
Half a world away from the fighting, but determined to be heard, supporters of Ukraine marched through Sydney's CBD.
Ukraine will win!
Demanding tougher penalties be imposed against Russian President Vladimir Putin.
The sanctions that should have happened had to be those sanctions from hell.
Australia's foreign minister today confirmed the government is exploring doing just that.
It is an exceptional step to sanction leaders, but this is an exceptional situation.
For now, it won't expel Russian diplomats from Australia, instead targeting those in Putin's inner circle. Eight oligarchs close to the president, the latest to be hit with sanctions, designed to put pressure on the regime.
They are impactful and significant sanctions. They are highly targeted, they are highly focused, and they are coordinated.
The United States has gone one step further with the support of NATO.
And in alignment with the decision by our European allies, the United States will join them in sanctioning President Putin and Foreign Minister Lavrov and members of the Russian National Security Team.
We will do what it takes to protect and defend every ally and every inch of NATO territory.
It's not only political sanctions aimed to hit Russia where it hurts. The Eurovision Song Contest has blocked the country from entering this year's competition, ruling any inclusion of a Russian entry would bring the competition into disrepute. And Formula One bosses have moved to cancel the Russian Grand Prix, determining it would be impossible to hold under the current circumstances. Meanwhile, the Chinese president and Vladimir Putin spoke last night, President Xi refusing to condemn Russia's actions or even call it an invasion. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.